Today I start the chapter General Programming and Decision Making in Java. In this chapter, the basic idea is to give a concept about Java programming. The general programming we have already discussed about the conditional and unconditional statement, which will help to give a detailed idea of writing Java instruction in a program. The instruction written in any Java program comprises of statement. Each statement terminates with a semicolon. That is, it is a statement which acts an instruction to display the message welcome. Welcome on the screen and ends with a semicolon as a statement terminator. This is statement terminator. Multiple statements within the second bracket are known as compound statement. The above block is called compound statement block. Now, Java packages. For now, I am going to discuss about Java packages for mathematical function. At first, we have to know what is package. Package is a collection of class to perform various functions. Package is a collection of class to perform various function. Every packages has a name and it can be included within the program by using the keyword import. Programming is a set of instruction to give a computer to perform a specific task. And package is a collection of a class to perform various functions. Every package has a name, it can be included within the program by using the keyword import. However, some of the mathematical functions are called automatically by the system by default to perform the desired task. Now we can illustrate some of the mathematical functions which are frequently used in the program. First function is math.sqrt. math.sqrt. This function is used to find the square root of a positive number. Square root of a positive number. Remember, it returns a double type data. So it return should be double. Now I am giving one example. Double n equal to math dot sqrt 4.0. It returns a double type value for n as 2.0. Next function is math dot mean. This function returns minimum of two numbers. The return value depends on the values used as the argument of the program. That is, if the argument is integer number, the result is integer number. I am giving one example. It returns an integer type value of n as 4, which is minimum of 4 and 6. If double n equal to math dot mean 4.6, 2.8. What will be the result? The result will be 2.8. And it will be double, but because it is given double and it is also declared as double. Next function is math dot max. This function is used to find the maximum of two given arguments. It returns a value depending upon the argument. That is, if two arguments are integer type, that returns value will be integer. If the two arguments are in double types, then returns value in double. Let int n equal to math dot max it returns an integer type maximum value of n equals to 6. So result will be n equal to 6. Next is math dot pow. This function is used to find the power raised to a specific base number. It always returns a double type value. Double d equal to math dot pow 2.0 power 3.0. So result will be d equal to 2.0 to the power 3.0, that is 8.0. Next function is math.log. This function returns natural logarithm value of given argument. It always returns a double time. It returns a double type value to x as 1.8325. Next function is math.abs. This function is used to return absolute value, that is only magnitude of the number. It returns int, long, double value depending upon the argument supplied. Example, int n equal to 3. It returns as integer value to n as 3. It returns an integer value to the variable n as n equal to 8. It returns a double type value to the variable n as 3.66. It returns a double type values to variable n as 9.9. This function is used to return the absolute value, that is only magnitude of the number. Clear? Now math dot round. This function returns the value in rounded form. It always returns an integer data type. If the fractional part of the number is below 0.5, it returns the same integer. If the fractional part of the number is below 0.5, it returns the same integer of the argument. Otherwise, it returns the next integer value. Int n equal to 0.5. It will return as integer value n as 6 because it is 0.25. If the fractional part of the number is below 0.5, so it returns the same integer, so it returns 6. It will return n equal to 6 because it is 0.85. It will return the value n equal to minus 9 because it is 0.92. Next function is math.floor. This function is also used to round the given number. It returns a number down to the nearest integer. down to the nearest integer. The outcome is always a double type number. Double type. One example. Double in it returns n equal to 6.0 because the function is down to the nearest integer. It will return only n equal to 6.0. Minus 6.25. It will return n equal to minus 7.0. It will also return n equal to minus 7.0. Because this function is used number down to the nearest integer. Number down to the nearest integer. Next is map dot cell. This function also provides the rounded value to the next higher integer. It returns a double. Also return double. Double n equal to map dot cell 6.25. So it will return the value n equal to 7.0 because the function tells the rounded value to the next higher integer. Rounded value to the next higher integer. Next higher integer is 7. So it will be 7.0. It will also give the result n equal to 7.0. It will returns n equal to minus 6.0. It will return n equal to minus 6.0. Next is map dot sign, map dot cos, map dot tan. These are the trigonometrical function. They are used to find the sine, cos, tan values respectively of the given angle in radian. Syntax is double d equal to, it is also double type, double d equal to mat dot sin x. You want to find the value of x, sin x. So value is given to x. You want to find the cosine value of x. So you write double d equal to mat dot cos x. It will return the cosine value of x. If you want to get the value in tan, so you write double d equal to mat dot tan x. Here argument x is an angle provided in radian, x in radian. The angles are measured in degree. Thus, it is necessary to convert them from degree to radian to perform the above task. Suppose you want to calculate the value of sine 30 degree. Sine 30 degree. Let int a equal to 30, int x is equal to in radian, then double. Double d equal to mat dot sine x. It returns the value of sine as you give the value in degree. Now you convert into radian. Now you perform the corresponding sine value. Next function is mat dot exp. This function provides exponential value, that is e to the power x. It returns double type. You will return 518.018. Next is mat dot rint. It returns the integer part of the number by removing the fractional part. Look at an example. It removes the fractional part, so d will return 6.0. If d will return 8.0. Next is random function. This function returns a random number between 0 and 1. It is returns a double type data. Normally the value is a fractional number. Example, it will returns any double value to D between 0 to 1. Now general programming in Java. In order to perform some specific tasks in program, you may need various mathematical functions to perform the desired tasks. In this segment, we will discuss about the general programming to develop the basic ideas. As you know that the program is a set of instructions which need some data values to get the result. Java language provides various ways to get the data values within the program. They are by assigning the value, first one is by using assign the value by BlueJay system, by input stream, by using scanner class, by using command line argument. Now go to first one, by assigning the value. In this segment, we assign the value in the program, and according to the given data, operation is performed. We added 3 numbers and we assign the value here, a equal to 5, b equal to 6, c equal to 4. According to the assigning the value, the addition is performed. So this is assigning the value. Next, using BlueJay system, BlueJay system. This is one of the method to accept the value from the user at the time of execution of the program. The data types of the variable are declared within the main. Example is the above function will accept two different values from the user of the defined data types, and after manipulation the output of the program is obtained off the screen. Write a simple program. In the above program, we input two numbers A, B. At the time of the execution of the program, the value A and B is given to the program. And according to the values, the operation will perform and you will get the value of C on the display window. Next is input using stream reader. Stream reader. Packages is basically collection of class. Each packages includes related built-in function which may be used while developing the programming logic. In order to develop a program using stream, some of the function related with input and output operations are invoked. Buffer. CPU or processor is the fastest device in a computer. Other peripheral device means which are connected with CPUs. Other peripheral device are comparatively slower than processor. Due to speed difference, it becomes difficult to have data communication between processor and peripheral device. Hence, a high-speed memory is applied between peripheral device and CPU. CPU used a bridge to synchronize their speed. This high-speed temporary storage known as cache memory. Is termed as buffer. You need to activate buffer before any input output operations. Activating buffer. This is a user-friendly statement where you can accept the value from console at the time of execution of the program. However, you should take care of the following points using stream reader. Declaring. At first, you have to import java.io. Declaring a Java library package at the beginning of the program, it allows performing all types of input and output tasks during the execution of the program. So you have to import java.io. Next point is declaring buffer to store data at the time of execution along with the 5 exception with the main. Declaring buffer to store data value at the time of the execution along with the IO exception. You have to write IO exception with main. Example, the main function is so special that it is implicitly invoked as the command is issued to execute the program. The statement throws IO's exception eliminates IO errors in the program, if any. If any IO errors occur, it eliminates. It passes the reports IO errors to the exception handler of the Java system. Now write the syntax. Now what is the syntax to giving integer type data using StreamReader? You write int n equal to integer dot parse int in dot read line. If you want to float n equal to float dot parse float in dot read line. Double n equal to double dot parse double in dot read line. Character char c equals to char in dot read. If you want to string c equal to in dot read line. Now input by using scanner class. The scanner class is the latest development in Java, which allows user to read values of various type. The scanner class is defined within a Java package, java.util. Scanner class is also available in the system package java.util. You have to import java.util package to perform the different tasks in scanner class. The process to import java.util package is shown below. The process to import java.util package, right, import java.util.scanner. Now how can I create scanner object? So creating scanner object. After importing java.util package, you have to got facility to avail scanner class and create object which can hold a set of value of different type. The syntax to create a scanner class object is scanner. Now write the name, object name equal to new scanner. The scanner class basically works on the principle of token in the input. A token is a series of characters that ends with delimiters. Some delimiters which can be used as token separator are comma, full stop, semicolon, white space. Scanner class use white space as default token separator. Now, what is the method to read token from the scanner object? Next int, it receives the next token from the scanner object which can be expressed as integer and stored in integer type variable. It receives next token. It receives next token from the scanner object which can be expressed as integer and stored integer type variable. So write next int. What is the syntax? Create the scanner object. It means the variable p stored as an integer through the object. Next float, it received the next token from the scanner object, which can be expressed as float, and stored the floating type variable. What is the syntax? Syntax is scanner in equal to new scanner system.in, float p, p equal to in dot next float. It means the variable p store a float value through the scanner object. This method receives the next token, which can be expressed as a double type, and syntax is double p equal to in dot next double. This method accepts the next token from the scanner object as string. A token can be defined by a set of characters between two simultaneous white space or delimiter. What is the syntax? It means the variable st stored the next token as a string from the scanner object. The application of next method is to accept a token as a string from the scanner object. When a line of text is input to the scanner object, the next method will receive the first token. The rest part of the text line can be obtained as a token by using next line. In case next method is not applied before the next line method, result in the entire line of the text. What is the example? Input through command line argument. This is one of the way to accept the data values from the user and send the argument to the main. It does not require Java packages to perform input and output tasks. While accepting the values from the console, the system stores the values in the different location as array of string. The size of the array can be determined by using the built-in args length. The argument to the main are passes or passes through ARGS0, ARGS1, ARGS2, so on. Generally, this system is not used to input value, but users should know the command line algorithm.